Welcome to Finance MCQ. I am CA Pritham Sangwan. Today we will discuss some of the important MCQs regarding Eastern Coalfields Limited Cost Accountant or Accountant Exams 2021. So let's start the video. Question number 1. Depreciation is allowed as deduction under dash section while computing income from business and profession. Option A, section 28. Option B, section 22. Option C, section 28. Option D, section 32. Or option E, none of the above. So yes, can you tell me what's the correct answer? So friends, depreciation is allowed as deduction under section 32 of Income Tax Act. So the correct option is option D, section 32. Here just one information is missing in the question. Here they have to mention under which act. So here it has to be section 32 of Income Tax Act. So just one correction in this question. So now let's move on to the next question. Question 2. Additional deduction of up to rupees dash is allowed as deduction for the amount deposited by taxpayer to their NPS account under section 80CCD 1B. Options are option A 80,000, option B 1 lakh, option C rupees 50,000, option D rupees 20,000, or option E none of the above. So yes, can you tell me the correct answer? So friends, here we are talking about additional deduction, not the original deduction, and that too under sections 80CCD 1B. So here the correct answer is option C, 50,000, that is allowed as additional deduction under this section. It is a maximum allowed deduction under this section. So now let's move on to the next question. Question 3. When the items of inventories are classified according to the value of usage, the technique is known as option A, Six Sigma, option B, ABC analysis, option C, theory of contribution, option D, Pareto analysis, option E, none of the above. So yes, can you tell me what's the correct answer? Friends, here we are talking about classification of inventory based on value of usage. So the correct answer is option B, ABC analysis. So what happened in ABC analysis? We bifurcate inventory in three category, A, B and C. A has all high value inventory and B has moderate level of inventory value and C are all low value inventory. So we have to put more focus or more control on my high value inventory because it's the costly one and its total value in inventory is significantly high. So almost here we have around 70 to 80%, then in the moderate category and the low category the remaining one. So accordingly we bifurcate as per ABC analysis based on the value of inventory. So the correct answer is option B, ABC analysis. So I hope the question is clear. Now let's move on to the next question. Question 4. Time required to recover the initial cash outflow is known as option A, payback period, option B, discounting period, option C, capital recovery period, option D, investment recovery period, or option E, internal recovery period. So yes, what's the correct answer? So friends, here we are talking about how much time it will take to recover my initial cash outflow. So the correct option is option A, payback period. Friends, usually investor would like to know how much time he will take to recover his initial cash or capital inflow that he put in the project. So by calculating payback period, we can identify how much time it will take. So I hope it is clear. Now let's move on to the next question. Question 5. Smoking is not allowed inside the cafeteria. This statement relates to which type of plan formed by an organization? Option A, budgetary. Option B, procedural. Option C, strategy. Option D, rules. Option E, none of the above. So yes, can you tell me the correct answer? Friends, smoking is not allowed inside the cafeteria. It's a rule. So option D is correct answer. And friends, rules spells out actions or non-actions which a employee, workers, etc. are to be followed. And these are framed टू क्रिएट इन्वायरमेंट ऑफ डिसिप्लिन. सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन डी रूल्स. आई होप इट इज क्लियर. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन 6. अ लार्ज स्केल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन यूजुअली हैव अ डैश टाइप ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल स्ट्रक्चर. ऑप्शन ए सेंट्रलाइज्ड, ऑप्शन बी डिसेंट्रलाइज्ड, ऑप्शन सी कैजुअल, ऑप्शन डी ओपन, ऑप्शन ई नन ऑफ द अबव. सो यस, व्हाट्स द करेक्ट आंसर. फ्रेंड्स, हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट लार्ज स्केल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, नॉट अ स्मॉलर वन. सो सिंस इट्स अ बिग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, अ सिंगल पर्सन कैन नॉट टेक ऑल द डिसीजन. सो वॉट ही नीड्स टू हैव डिफरेंट पीपल हु विल टेक डिसीजन्स और हु विल रन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो हेयर बेसिकली वी विल हैव decentralized organizational structure. So the correct answer is option B, decentralized. Here authorities are decentralized at all level of management. So here the different authority will be there at this level, different authority responsibility will be there, like top, middle and floor management levels. So I hope it is clear. Now let's move on to the next question. Question 7. MICR technology used for clearance of check by bank refers to A. Magnetic ink character recognition, option B. Magnetic intelligence character recognition, option C. Magnetic information cable recognition, option D. Magnetic insurance cases recognition, or option E. None of the above. So yes, can you tell me the correct answer? Friends, MICR stands for Magnetic Ink Character Recognition. So the correct option is option A. So I hope this question is also clear. Now let's move on to the next question. Question 8. AS-18 related to option A. Revenue Recognition, option B. Plant Property and Equipment, option C. Employee Benefits, option D. Borrowing Cost, option E. Related Party Disclosure. So yes, can you tell me the correct answer? Friends, AS-18 relates to related party disclosure. My borrowing cost is AS-16, employee benefit is AS-15, PPE is my AS-10, and my revenue is AS-9. So the only correct answer is option E. So now let's move on to the next question. Question 9. Companies having net worth greater than dash should form corporate social responsibility committee. Your options are A. Rs. 500 crores, B. Rs. 50 crores, option C. Rs. 250 crores, option D. Rs. 1000 crores, option E. None of the above. So yes, can you tell me the correct answer? Friends, the correct answer is net worth greater than Rs. 500 crore. So the correct option is option A, 500 crores. Friends, as per section 135 of Companies Act, every company having net worth of rupees 500 crores or more, or turnover rupees 1000 crores or more, or net profit of rupees 5 crores or more in any financial year shall constitute a corporate social responsibility committee. So do keep this in mind. It's an important question and can be asked in your exam. So now let's move on to the next question. Question number 10. Where GST tariff itself indicates GST rate as nil, it will be a exempt supply, option B nil rated supply, option C non GST supply, option D either of the above, option E none of the above. So yes, what's the correct answer? Friends, in this case, here the GST tariff rates indicate that it's a nil rate. So basically it's a nil rated supply. So option B is the correct answer. And friends, it implies that goods or service is taxable. We are not saying that it's not taxable, it is taxable, but tax rate is nil. So do keep this in mind. There is a difference between non-taxable service and taxable service having a nil rate. In case of second one, the goods or service is chargeable to tax, but at present the rate is nil. So do keep this in mind. Friends, to practice more such kind of MCQ, please visit our website financemcq.in. Here we are presenting entire ECL accountant or cost accountant exam course in MCQ format for practice and a quick revision. here we are presenting in subject wise, topic wise MCQ, and more than 2500 quality MCQs are there prepared by CACMA. Friends, it is the simplest and fastest way to complete your full technical syllabus, which is having weightage of around 60 to 80%. And friends, it will be a positive booster to your practice and will bring you one step closer to a selection. And you will also get email support for clarification of doubt. So do visit Finance MCQ website, take a demo for ECL course, and you will realize that the course is of a quality nature and will help you for your preparation. So thank you so much for watching this video till the end.